Hello students, in this third lecture of machine drawing we are going to discuss about conventional representation of machine components. Earlier we had a discussion on materials, conventional representation of materials. This time we are going to discuss about machine components. For example, bearings, leaf springs, spline shafts, and knurling, that could be straight knurling or diamond type of knurling, and screw threads and external threads, square shaft, many other types are there. Now basically drawing these sketches are very much easier the way we look into the textbook or the way we listen to our classes. It looks so simple, but when it comes to actual practice there are many questions in students' mind, like where to start, how to start, how to maintain the conventional angles. As I said, conventional representation nothing but there will be our own dimensions. There won't be any standard dimensions or specifications given. To remember, we need to take our own specifications or dimensions based on the requirement of the space on our drawing sheet. So here student will get confused, like what are the lengths or diameters or radius need to be followed for to draw bearings or leaf springs or screws or knurlings or screw threads. Many questions. So in such case we need to represent how to I'll show you how to represent, how to take the dimensions in the simplest way. First, for example, bearings, conventional representation of machine components. First component is about bearing. What is the conventional representation? In general practice, if you would like to draw actual bearing, it will take long time, much time. So I'll tell you how. Now, for example, industrially, if you draw, the bearing representation will be something like this. There will be a rectangle. You need to show a ball. To show the bearing, you need to represent something like this. There will be a ball bearing. If it is a ball bearing, you need to show something like this with an axis line followed by one more. This is a representation. Okay. So theoretically, the representation is different. And practically, industrially, if you'll see, the representation is different. So practically we are making it so simple, we are not showing all the intricate shapes. We are drawing a rectangle with simple 2D lines that represents a bearing. Similarly, our leaf spring also. I'll start off with straight knurling. What actually knurling is all about? Knurling is used in a machine component for gripping purpose, gripping of your hand. If it is smooth, you can't hold it, you can't turn it. You can't fasten it or unfasten it unless you have a knurling on it. Okay, it all depends whether you deal with a straight knurling or a diamond knurling. It all depends from component to component, or it all depends on the application point. Fine. Now, to show a straight knurling, I'll start off with a simple shaft followed by the cut section, then again the knurling portion. Maybe this is the knurling portion or the representation where you need to represent the knurling part. So now this is conventional. You can take a diameter of 20 and you can take or follow a width of 20 or 30 mm or 40 mm, this width. Okay, then followed by the length of some 40 mm or 50 mm. It all depends. 40 mm or 50 mm means conventionally you can take your convenient distances. Okay, then again knurling. You need to draw straight lines like this, 1, 2, 3, 4 parallel lines, okay, which will maintain an offset distance of again 2 mm. If you could remember conventional representation of materials, they'll be followed. Okay, 2 mm, you need to follow. Fine. Now before doing this, take your drafter, align it to the horizontal edge of your sheet, then draw two parallel vertical lines, two parallel vertical lines with 2H pencil. Okay, parallel vertical lines with 2H pencil. In between those two lines, try to maintain that. Try to maintain this offset distance of 2 mm. Okay, this is about straight narrowing. Straight lining nothing but straight parallel lines which will maintain 2 mm gap in between. Okay, and there will be a uniformity throughout. Justification will be there. Afterwards, if you want, you can erase these two vertical lines with 2H pencil, or else you can remain it, not a problem. Fine, this is about straight knurling. Similarly, if you would like to draw a diamond knurling, draw a shaft followed by a rectangular piece of your own dimensions, then again followed by two parallel lines with 2H pencil. Fine. Again, align your drafter this time to 45 degrees inclination. Then again, maintain 2, 4, 6, gap of 2 mm. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. Likewise, it all depends on the length you consider. Then again, align your drafter to 45 degrees inclination. Theta is equal to 45 degrees. Then draw parallel lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Fine. In a similar fashion, align your drafter to minus 45 degrees. 1, 2, 3, 4. In a reverse way, where you could see diamonds in between. Okay. Why we call it as diamond knurling means you could see 1, 2, 3, 4 diamond kind of shape in between two inclinations. Now, this is the representation of what? Diamond knurling. Okay. Now, these two are used for gripping purpose. Okay. To fasten or unfasten any of the knobs. Okay. The application point might be different compared to both the things. Okay. In a similar fashion, most of the students will get confused to draw a leaf spring, because the leaf spring will be something like this, which will have more number of curves, more radiuses. How to draw these radiuses? This is a very big question mark to them. Okay, to draw this leaf spring, simply draw one vertical axis. Okay, then take one center point over it. Anywhere, arbitrarily take one point. Okay, take your compass, consider any of the radius, maybe 25 mm, mm or 30 mm. Okay, take this as center one, place your compass sharp end, then draw a curve. Okay, symmetrically with respect to vertical, symmetrically. This half should be equivalent to this half. Okay, then again, what you need to do? Draw a 2 mm vertical, both the sides, 2 mm vertical. Okay, with the same center, this has the radius. From here to this point, end point as a radius, draw one more curve. Fine. Again, from here, maintain some offset distance. Some means 4 mm, 5 mm, maybe 10 mm, your convenience. Draw 2 mm line again. Whatever the distance you have maintained here, same need to be followed to the other side also. Fine. To the other side also. Symmetrical. Fine. Again, maintain same center followed by the end point as the radius. Draw this curve. Fine. Here, remember one thing, we are not going to change the center to draw a leaf spring. Again, maintain some offset distance on either side of the vertical with that same center and the radius, or till the end point, curve, draw a curve. Okay, draw a curve. Ultimately, you'll get a leaf spring. Now again, for your convenience, I'll make it so simple now. Again, I'm repeating. From here to this point, this acts as R1. From here to this point, this acts as R2. Okay. From here to this point, it is R3. Here to this point again, R4. Now the radiuses are keep on changing. Center will remain same. what is the concept here? Radius will change all the time, fine, whereas center remain same. Got it? Center will remain always same. Okay, to the ends you can place this position point simply, fine. This is the theoretical representation to draw a leaf spring. In general practice, industrially, conventionally, if you'll see, there will be a simple straight axis, and similar to that there will be a center point C1 with some conventional radius or dimension. We'll try to draw a curve, fine. This time, in this case, we'll try to change the center, not the radius. We'll try to change the center. Okay, maybe C1 is here, C2 is below that. Conventionally, that also, don't take 2 mm, 3 mm, standard one. It is not a standard one. You can take your own dimensions. If C1 is here with some gap, take C2. From C2 to, again, take this as radius, draw one more curve. Okay, it will be almost like a half moon, fine. If this from here to here, it acts as R1, here to here, it is again acts as R2, fine. Now, in this case, what happened? Now, this is the theoretical representation. This is practical representation, conventional representation, what you call. Centers will change. Centers will change, radius will also change. In case of conventional representation, center change, so radius will also change for leaf spring. Whereas in case of theoretical representation, center will remain same, radius will keep on change. Okay, you can take as many number of steps as you want, but preferably we'll go up to 3 or 4 levels, fine. Now, one more important point need to be noted. While drawing a spring, compressive spring or any tension spring, people will face, students will face difficulty. What are those? Now, how to draw the compression spring? Take a axis line, any convenient distance or width. I'll consider some 20-20 mm on either side of what you call a vertical axis line, then followed by 45 degrees inclination line. Okay, 45 degrees, with a gap of 2 mm, draw one more 45. Okay, with a gap of some 4 mm, draw two more lines. 4 mm again, draw two more lines. Okay, now join them both with the help of freehand curve. Join them both something like this with freehand. Okay, then again draw some cross line, 45 degrees cross line, 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, take one more for proper understanding. Take one more with an offset of 4 mm, join them both, 1, 2. Okay, this is how we'll show the compressor. Take a horizontal on the top, then a vertical. Okay, this is how we represent what? Cylindrical compression spring. Cylindrical compression spring. Okay, now these are maintaining what? 45 degrees inclination. Now this line is maintaining 45 degrees inclination. 45 degrees inclination. Okay, now in between these two lines there is a gap of 2 mm. Okay, again there is a gap in between these two. I'm taking it as some 4 mm. You can go up to 6 mm also, not a problem, because it is the conventional representation. And I have taken 1, 2, 3, 4 stages. You can go up to 4 stage, 6 stage, 5 stage. It all depends on the space availability of your drawing sheet. Okay, but in general, if you go up to 3 or 4, that is enough. No need to go with much things. Now this is the conventional representation. When it comes to theoretical part or practically, simply what we try to do, we'll try to draw an axis line followed by simple horizontal zigzag line. 1 horizontal, 2 horizontal, 3 horizontal, 4 horizontal. Now this is the practical representation, what you call conventional representation. Industrially, if you'll go or see, the representation will be like this, because this will take much time, this will take very less time. That is the main motto. Okay, theoretically we always, all the time we never represent theoretically, we'll go with some conventional representations also. It all, the stages again depends on you, and this will maintain an angle of 45 degrees and the gap is your wish. Maybe I'm going with some 5 mm. Okay, so here I'm not dealing with all the components, because few of the components are very much simple to represent. And in case of diamond knurling also, this is the theoretical representation, you can call, or the subject point. Fine. Conventionally, if you want to represent, simply take a box. Simply take a box. No need to use any of the drafter or scale. Simply draw those diamond shapes with your free hand. Draw the diamond shapes. These are enough to draw the diamond knurling. Similarly, in case of straight knurling also, simply draw the box. Draw 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5 lines. That is enough. No need to draw from top to bottom. Only few representation, few lines are enough to represent a straight knurl. Few boxes, diamond boxes, are enough to represent a diamond knurling. This is what, these two are conventional representation of straight knurling, diamond knurling. Practical representation of straight and diamond knurlings. Okay. Now this is the theoretical representation. Similarly, these two are, this is what, practical, I mean theoretical representation. This is practical or conventional representation of compression spring. Likewise, you have many other. Similarly, you find difficulty while drawing splined shaft also. Splined shafts, simple to draw. I'll make a note. Now draw a 2-H circle, complete circle. Okay, followed by one more concentric circle with an offset distance of some 2 or 4 mm. It all depends on your space availability. Okay, then draw this knurling with some gap, with the help of small scale, not the drafter, small scale. Okay, small scale, draw this specification. Then try to erase these lines, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If you remove that line, then you could see this spline curve, circle 1, then a spline, circle 1, then again one more spline, circle 1, one more spline, something like this. Okay, now this is your circle 1 and this is circle number 2, which you have drawn here already. Okay, now this top end help you. Now the second circle number 2 will help you to draw the top end. Only thing is, you are drawing these two internal lines which are somewhat inclined to each other. Okay, this is how you do. Now here I'm trying to show you how to draw the conventional representation of machine components, and students will face few problems while drawing. That is what I'm trying to show. Okay, simply. And one more thing is, this is the practical application. What you call theoretically, how you represent theoretically, this is the way to represent while drawing a rectangle with balls and the bearing arrangement. In general, they'll draw something like this. There will be a box, axis, followed by the partition, followed by simple cross lines. This is the representation of a bearing. Any engineer will understand that these two cross lines indicates that this is the position of a bearing. No need to draw the complete stuff which is there in the theoretical part. Simply draw a rectangle, do the partitions, give the cross lines. That is enough to represent the bearing. Any engineer throughout the universe will understand that this is the representation of a bearing, this is the representation of a diamond knurling, this is the representation of a straight knurling, this is the representation of a cylindrical compressive spring, this is the representation of a shaft with splines. Okay, so here I'm not drawing any, I mean all the things, because time is the constraint. Here I'm trying to show you how to draw the critical portion of a machine component. Okay, that is my intention. If you have any doubts, any queries, you can mail me, you can be in contact anytime. Thank you so much for watching.